Just 3 months ago, George T's GT Capital planned on bidding for two government PPP projects. Today, the company said it is dropping its PPP agenda. Michelle Ong tells us why.
GT Capital has a big secret. The holding company of business taipan George T says it stumbled on a potentially big investment. That's why it's dropping government PPPs from its agenda, at least for now.
We came across a potential investment or acquisition opportunity that is a closer fit to our business model. So currently, we're evaluating.
GT Capital earlier expressed interest in the 123 billion peso Laguna Lakeshore project and the LRT Line 2 extension project. It did not submit documents to qualify for either. GT Capital CFO Francisco Suarez Jr. was tight-lipped about the said plan, but shared that if things work out, they should be able to make an announcement in the next 6 to 12 months. COL financial analyst Charles Ang says it's hard to guess what kind of acquisition GT Capital is making. It has gotten into unrelated businesses like Toyota in 1988 and Power in 2003. But he says if he had to guess, he's betting GT Capital would buy something they can relate to their existing businesses, which also include banks, insurance, and real estate. Suarez did say the potential acquisition will be a very big contributor to their business. Right now, its auto business, Toyota Motor Philippines, has the biggest contribution at 36%, and GT Cap believes it still has a lot of room to grow.
Auto density here in the Philippines, our auto density here is only 20 cars for every 1,000. If you compare the Philippines with other our ASEAN neighbors, Malaysia is about 300 cars for every 1,000. Indonesia is around 60 cars for every 1,000. Thailand is around 80 cars for every 1,000. So there's a lot of room for growth. Mr. Sugata-san actually projected 200,000 sales, but this will happen in 2020. Normally, the first quarter is a lean period for auto sales. So we expect, sales to pick up. Normally, in the second and the fourth quarters are the peak periods.
Suarez also told ANC, if history is to be a guide, auto sales usually grow over 20% during national elections and 15% during local elections. Suarez is also very bullish about Metrobank. Metrobank took the worst hit among the big three banks from weak trading gains in 2014. It was also a drag in GT Capital's earnings.
With the proceeds from the recently concluded stock rights offering, they were able to raise 32 billion. They would be able to deploy most of the funds for lending. And this will go to basically small and medium scale enterprise, the consumer sector, the commercial sector. So these are the middle markets that the bank has been concentrating.
GT Capital has its hands full this year, but here are some things it won't be doing. Expansion overseas, expanding its power business in Luzon, which it says already has so many players, and getting into gaming. GT Capital was the top index gainer Wednesday, bucking PSE's downswing. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.